Okay, so we are just at home with Miss Natalie Morales.
Yeah, I know, it's like we're sitting on the couch just having a conversation.
She is our co-host, our third co-host for the afternoon, and we're so excited to have you here because you have a brand new cookbook that you have rolled out, and we've been talking about it before you came on camera at home with Natalie, and we have some good stuff in store for people, don't we?
Oh, I love, I mean, what I loved about putting this book together, it sort of allowed me to take a trip down memory lane. It's a lot of the places, many homes that I've lived in over my life, because I've lived all over the world, Panama, Brazil, Spain. I was an Air Force brat, so I was really blessed to have an upbringing that allowed me to travel so much and see so many places, but this book is infused with recipes from all of these beautiful places that I've lived in or traveled to, and a lot of healthy recipes in there as well.
That's something that I really like because, first of all, you know, you have an interesting background.
Yeah.
The Brazilian and
Puerto Rican.
Mm-hmm. And a lot of the comfort foods sometimes aren't the healthiest.
But
so you've put your own little spin on it so that you can still enjoy the good stuff.
I'm all about comfort.
Yeah. Ooh,
okay. And comfort foods. So, you know, for me, like, no mac and cheese. I mean, come on. You got to have the ability to eat mac and cheese. And you got to have a good hamburger every now and again, too. So I'm all about that.
She says it all the time.
But there are ways to make those foods better for you, like the mac and cheese in my book. I make it with cauliflower as well, so it adds like a creamy texture, and butternut squash, so it gives it a little bit of that orange coloring.
Nice.
Packed with nutrients. My kids don't know there are vegetables in there, which you have young children, Michelle, so you know sometimes sneaking the veggies is the only way to get them to eat it. There is still cheese, though. You can't cut back on the cheese and the mac and cheese. Just a little bit, though.
Yeah, you can't cut corners on the cheese. And also, I thought it was really interesting, because of your background, you are a self-proclaimed military brat.
Mm-hmm.
It's not just like Brazilian and Puerto Rican food, Chinese food.
Yes, yes.
All different types.
Places we've lived or traveled to, and also just foods that I love. And as a journalist, I've been able to travel for the Today Show all over the world.
Yeah,
so, you know, at the Olympics in Greece, I just came back from South Korea. So everywhere I go, I always pick up a little something, even if it's just the spice, or I learn something about that culture. To be able to cook them the recipes at home, because I do love to feel like we are a global community and we are seeing people love and embrace foods and spices from all over the world so much more. So this is a book that I feel it honors many cultures and experiences that I've been able to have.
Speaking of honoring, you said that this cookbook really is a way for you to honor your family, your mom. Remember kind of pulling at her dress, you know, as she was cooking.
Yeah.
You were in the kitchen from a young age, so this is something that you've been doing for a long time.
Yeah, you know, it's part of that Latin upbringing. Mm-hmm. You stand next to your mom in the kitchen and you learn alongside her. And, you know, I'm one of three girls. I'm the middle child. And so we all now participate. Any holiday, we're standing around helping my mom make her empanadas or whatever, you know, the recipe is.
Mm-hmm.
But for us, it really is about family. And this book is preserving my family's legacy, but it's also, I want it to inspire people to preserve their own memories and their own legacies in the kitchen. So I hoped by writing my story, it's also allowing people to share their own stories.
And I love that.
Let's talk about that, because you just launched a new website.
I did.
And that's where you're inviting people to share their stories.
To share their stories, because working in local news, I've done it as well as you all do. And you know, there's so many great stories and people who inspire. And so now I've launched this website, NatalieMorales.me. It's in conjunction with a cookbook, whether it's recipes you want to share or people in your life who have done incredible things. If you have a great story, share it. And it's stories around the table. Again, to me, like having that dinner time is sacred time, or sitting down. I know we're all busy. We're working, you know, moms in many cases. It's so hard to carve out that family time, but sharing stories, and this is the idea of a web community where you can share those stories as well and start conversations in a positive way, because too often we all know the haters online, right?
Oh, yeah.
We all deal with that.
Yes.
So this
them.
Is a way for positive interactions online.
We need that uplift, right?
Yeah.
That's a good thing. Now, one thing I have to point out, I said, you know what? She's a woman after my own heart, because this is what I love about you. You said that, you know, you're trying something different with your food. You're doing some vegan, but you said wine is vegan.
Yes.
Wine is vegan.
Wine is definitely vegan, and it's good for you. All the doctors say a glass of red wine a day. I subscribe completely to cooking with wine too.
Okay.
And having it be, it's my main ingredient, and it's also next to me most.
Yes. There you go. See?
One more question. We have 30 seconds. We have to wrap, but any possibility of a Natalie Morales cooking show, perhaps?
Ooh. Oh, you know, I don't know. I mean, I hadn't thought of that. I mean,
Because there's some videos
the
that I've
seen.
The
door is always open.
You're great at it.
She's a natural. Yes. Because you can go on YouTube and catch some of the videos as she's making these recipes. And I think, I have to tell you, I'm a fan of the cooking, all the cooking networks.
Me too. So
I know it's one of my favorites. And I would watch.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
So here on Food Network.
Let's get on it. Let's make it happen right here on News 3 Live at Noon. We're going to make it happen.